So what I've got here is just a very basic .NET 5 application that's an ASP.NET Core. So if we look at very basic program and startup, pretty much all of this template out of the box does is if I hit this endpoint right here, and I think I can zoom a little bit on that too. Oh, the zoom's going really slow, so we won't do too much of that. Plus, although, I got my tooltips.
I appreciate the use of zoom it though. I'm always a fan of that.
We'll bump this up a little bit, but so I've got this map git. So I have this running, and if we look at the website, we get this very boring hello world, which is right up here. So that's our starting point. So the
and you set that up by using .NET new, correct? Which is a command line utility.
Yes. Okay. I did literally .NET new ASP.NET Core, I think, -o and subdirectory or whatever have you for that.
Okay.
All right. So let us add some GraphQL love to this. And what I'm going to use is there's two very popular .NET frameworks for GraphQL. There's GraphQL Net, and there's Hot Chocolate. Hot Chocolate happens to be one I'm more familiar with. I've done more with that, so I'm going to choose that. It's not saying it's better, but that's the one I'm going with for this scenario. I think a lot of people are actually familiar with Hot Chocolate. So
I like
we're going to go. You like Hot Chocolate?
I love Hot Chocolate.
But we're going to get into some other cool names too. So let me see how fast I can add Hot Chocolate to this application.
And okay. Just to clarify, so Hot Chocolate, this is an open source project that you're including here.
That is correct.
Okay.
In fact, if we look, now we've got Hot Chocolate. I'm using the latest and greatest 12.0 preview. So that's the only thing I've added here. And if we go into my program startup, we can see in typical ASP.NET middleware fashion, I've got a add GraphQL server here. So I'm adding the middleware, then I'm configuring the middleware. I'm saying map GraphQL to that endpoint. So that's the only change I've made. Now what's happened here is if we refresh our endpoint, we get banana cake pop. What is banana cake pop? This is a built-in IDE, sort of similar to what you would get with a Swagger swashbuckle that allows me to interact with GraphQL endpoints. Now, I'm not going to zoom or show any capabilities now because I haven't defined any endpoints, but the IDE is here and ready-made. That's something Hot Chocolate provides out of the box as a way to interface with it. And of course, just like anything else, you can turn it off for production so you don't have people hacking on your APIs, but we're going to use this to explore what I'm building while I'm building it.
Okay.
All right, so what I'm doing now is I'm adding a class for blog. It's a pretty straightforward class, ID, name, URL, has some posts. I have a post class. And then I wanna create a type that's gonna be my first resolver that tells GraphQL that there's something that I want it to expose. We're going to evolve this over time, but right now by convention, I'm providing a query that you can make. So I have this class query. I've got a method called get blogs that I have as iQueryable. Although right now I've just hard coded, I'm being a little selfish, but developer for life, my blog, right? And so I'm just returning that as queryable. So that creates a place where I can get some data. Pretty simple place, but we're taking baby steps here. Now, if I look at my startup, you'll notice that in my middleware, I'm adding this query type of query. So I'm telling the GraphQL server that there's this class you can go to, and that class has methods on it that give you something interesting. So having done that, let's come back to banana cake pop, and let's actually zoom it a little bit. Refresh, and hopefully it doesn't do some wonky things like some things do when you zoom in the web. But now I've got this concept of a schema, and I do need to zoom out so I can refresh. Hold on. So I'm going to do new document. I'm going to refresh. And hopefully, as a result of that, we get some query completion. Let's see. See how it shows blogs?
Yeah.
So by convention, because I said git press, the little play button, you can see it gives me blogs name developer for life over here. Now, this is a lot more flexible than just that because I actually included a post on that. So let's say, and post refers back to blogs. So let's say I wanted to format it like this. Let's say I wanted blogs. And let me zoom again while I'm typing this. So I wanted blogs. And then within the blogs, I wanted posts. And in the posts, what I'm interested in is the title. And then I also would like the blog that the post belongs to. And that I just want the name.
Okay, so blog then is the entry point to everything. And so what you're doing here is you're going to step down and say, hey, I want all the posts. For all of the posts, I want the title. And then as a child property to each post, I then want the name of the blog. So you're basically sort of reversing the order there, correct?
Correct.
Okay.
All right, so let's play this. And now we get the post title and the blog with the name Developer for Life. So we've evolved it somewhat with that.